white. And you said you had made Kool-Aid ice cubes for the kids?
Yeah, I did.
Okay. So as you come in the house, Laney has, what is Laney, when you come into the house, Henley is doing what?
She's holding her with an ice pack on there.
What day is this?
That's Sunday. Sunday night, Sunday evening, late evening.
And then what did you, observe next?
Well, I went back towards the bedroom. So I could hear somebody in there. Went to the bedroom.
What could you hear?
Crying.
Got to the bedroom, what did you see?
I seen Kelsey with Laney in the bed. She was crying.
Who was crying?
Kelsey.
Describe to the jury what you were able to see. Experience in seeing animals no longer being alive.
Yes, I have. I've hunted all my life since I was 7 years old.
What sorts of animals have you hunted on your farm?
Deer, turkeys, coyotes, squirrel, birds, coons, just pretty much whatever the state has to offer up.
So when you were able to observe Laney, tell me if there's anything else that you can observe about her person, her body. Did she blink her eyes?
No, her eyes were fixed. And that were her pupils were not dilating, and they were just fixed. Her eyes didn't blink or move.
Could you tell if she was breathing?
She was not breathing. She didn't have a heartbeat in her pulse.
Can you tell members of the jury whether or not you were able to physically touch her skin flesh to flesh?
I did.
What then did you next do?
Told Kelsey that Laney, she's dead. I asked her what happened. She said it was an accident. She said that she put Laney upstairs in the attic in this little window type place. Put her there and left her there. She had her blankets up there and stuff. She had left her up there, and at some point in time, she went back up to check on her, and she said that she wasn't moving or breathing before I got back.
Can you tell exactly when Kelsey took Laney up to the attic?
I don't know. I was not there.
Can you tell exactly when Laney was brought down from the attic back?